Hi everyone, welcome back to Red Dead Redemption 2. I'm back where we left off, and I have just ridden back up to camp. That's the only thing that's really changed. Hey Karen, it's me.
It's me!
Hope you've been good out there.
Yeah, I've been a little bit naughty. Cool, I'm gonna hitch horse. I can do up the camp funds and maybe get everyone nicer tents and stuff after the big ol' heist we just did. So, yeah. Hopefully, can I feed you? Make you feel better? Yeah, and then let me brush you.
Yeah, I'll stay there, boy.
Beautiful. Alrighty, so.
Hey!
Hey.
You know something? When they was talking about hanging me, I just kept thinking of you.
Oh.
Oh, did you miss me? That's nice.
No. Precisely the opposite. I was thinking, even if I die, at least I won't have to see that tour no more.
Oh, I like that. That's funny. Yes, I'll remember that one.
Beautiful.
Very good.
Glad to hear. Kieran wants to go fishing. Interesting. Okay, we can do that. Let me put some money in the box and then get it up to 300 at least to make our camp nicer. Cool, let's do that. Lovely, and then ledger. Let's upgrade the tents. Okay, there we go. I have no answers for what just happened. Oh wait, here it is. Old camp boat. Met a traveler selling an old boat. Useful. But we have a boat. We just brought it over. Alright, for everyone. Purchase. I hope everyone's happy.
For you by your tent. Just to say thanks for the harmonica.
Okay.
Aww.
Thank you.
Thank you. Lovely.
Good morning, Arthur.
Morning. So, where's the flower? Okay, gun oil, which, good reminder, I should, I can't take my guns out in here, but I should clean my guns. Okay, let's have a sleep and restore my health till the morning. I know it's gonna be ages, but it's fine. Till the next day. And I'll definitely be sure to clean my guns. I've got so many new guns now. Righto. So. What we can do is, yeah, there's that Kieran fishing mission. Then there's also, oh yeah, getting money for, oh yeah, learning about the Greys. So yeah, there's getting money for Strauss. And then there's also this dude over here getting the animals, so that'll be fun. So yeah, let's head over to town and deal with Gwen when we can. And I guess early in the morning we could go fishing as well. Let me super quickly donate to P Pearson.
Haven't received anything from you in a while, Mr. Morgan.
I'm so sorry. I've been out and about. Let's donate both of those.
Very good. We were getting low. Well, I'll take what I can get. Can't have that pot go completely empty. Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
I got you. And let's once again grab this.
Good work, Arthur.
To the horses. Arthur's a hard-working man. Here we are. And let's donate money because it's a new day, and then I'll head off. Morning, Molly.
Hi. Morning.
Morning.
How are you doing, Molly?
Fine. Fed up of moving all the time.
Yeah, hopefully we won't have to for a little bit. Is.
Well, I should get back to it.
Well, I'm not much company. Take care.
Alrighty, cool. I'll do the fishing later. I'll first get...
I hear you've been getting into trouble again.
Oh, God, Reverend.
I never liked Catholics, Mr. Matthews, but maybe they're right. I need to confess.
You are a hot mess,
that's
dude.
That's a business I know nothing about, Reverend. That's between you and God.
Sometimes I feel as if he cared, he would have killed me years ago.
Righto.
Hey. Hey.
Oopsies. Sorry.
What is it?
I meant to.
You were snoring, that's all.
Sorry. Hey,
good morning.
I was about to say hi to Charles, not to wake you.
With us for less than a year.
A lot's happened.
Well, stick with us. We need you.
Yeah, we need you. You're good. Alrighty. Let's mount up and go get that money for Herr Strauss.
Hey, boy.
It's a new day, we're all feeling fresh, and, yep, heading there, but I'm also going to save just in case it goes really badly with this guy.
Yeah. How you doing, boy?
Off we go. Then maybe in the evening time I'll fish with Kieran.
Blink before I shoot you. Hurry up and nail. Get out of here.
boy. I don't want to mess with that. That's bad news. And Dutch said, do not ruffle feathers in this town. We need to keep a low profile. In places like where I killed all the O'Driscolls, yeah, I can be a menace there. I've already got a $300 bounty there. I may as well be a menace out there that way. But this way, we've got to be good boys. Exactly. Yeah, I listen to Dutch. Lovely. Something here? The Undertaker. Hello.
Not quite right.
The workshop?
I don't want no trouble. No, please don't go, please don't go. No.
I ain't never gonna get the hang of this.
Mister, how do I get in here?
I've been trapped down here. No, please don't go.
Dad don't care if it's pretty, right?
Here he is. Hey, Gwen.
Gwen Hughes, start picking out a box for yourself if you don't got that money you owe Leopold Strauss.
I need more time.
Doesn't everybody? That casket for you, or you want another?
Wait. I can get it for you.
Mm-hmm.
But,
Well?
Come with me to the churchyard. And stay close.
Yeah, I will.
All right.
You stay on your heels. So what do you mean?
This ain't right. I'll get you your money, but,
Not ethically?
Well, you'll see.
It's buried with someone.
It's borrowing money you can't pay back.
I guess you're correct, but, this, it ain't exactly right, what we're doing.
Right, Robin?
You ain't the first to put his hand in the collection box, and you won't be the last. Rest a little easier knowing church has been taking more than they need off poor folks since time began.
Like I said,
the morality of the matter is a little more confusing than that.
Okay, you head on in the church, I'll keep watch.
Well, it ain't in there. It's under here. I'm digging up Mrs. Claypole.
Yep.
Jesus!
Well, she got a bunch of jewels in there that she don't need.
Yeah, she don't need them. The hell's she gonna do with them?
Oh, damn it. There's a bunch of people here.
Mm.
Oh, I got it. Look, you clear them off, and I'll wait right around here. But don't hurt nobody. We don't want no fuss.
Okay. I don't know why I'm trusting you.
Don't be shy. Ain't no one around.
You two might want to find somewhere a little more private.
We was fine until you got here, mister. Good day now.
Get out of here, kids. Move!
Come on. I knew we shouldn't have been here.
You missed your chance, boy!
Oh, wait. There's another person. Oh, yeah. Oh, she's grieving. That's sad.
Ma'am, would you mind clearing out of here for some maintenance work?
Oh, gladly. It's about time this place got cleaned up.
Yeah. True. All right, he's not going to be there, is he? Oh no, he's a all right, good boy.
It's all clear.
All right. Now go watch the gate. I'll get to this exhumation.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, she's leaving. She was coming.
I'm sorry, ma'am. The church grounds are closed for maintenance work.
Yeah.
Well, it's about time, too. The place was in need of some care and attention.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You be well now. Gentlemen.
You and me would be running things.
Sure would.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Hey, look, we're closed for some excavation work. Would you mind?
No, I ain't gonna mind you at all. You carry on with your business, we'll carry on with ours. This fella. Oof.
Damn choir boy.
Get the hell out of this churchyard. Are you boys gonna need yourselves a preacher?
You hear this fella?
I heard him all right.
We're gonna lick you, bastard.
Lick me.
You gonna get it?
Shit. Hope this hole's dug.
Not bad. Righto.
All right, well, here's your payment.
Damn.
Oh, forgive me, Mrs. Claypole.
What'd you find?
But she had a brooch here. Looks like diamonds.
Diamonds? Okay. How do I get it?
Quick, take it before somebody sees us.
Girl, how? What the freak do I do? Oh. Okay. Oh, from you.
Oh, this will do. Now get out of here before someone sees you.
Can't believe it's come to this.
Yeah, that's what borrowing money will do.
I'm out of here.
See ya. Pleasure doing business.
Move out of the darn way.
Oh, God, it's just a dead deer there.
Again, friend.
Hey, friend.
How you keeping?
I'm miserable.
Because of the leg?
Ah, no, I'm used to the leg. I mean, I've been without it a whole lot longer than I was with it. Nah, it's a people. Hmm. Yeah, a bunch of nasty, miserable peasants I gotta share this place with.
Why don't you leave?
Leave? Well, I live here. They're my nasty, miserable people.
They're my nasty, miserable
for so
people.
Long, if I forgot to hate them, I wouldn't know what day it was. Yeah, but you, man, you ought to get out of here and you ought to stop coming back.
Can I give you any money? Okay. Will you be well? Alrighty.
Can I help you?
What do you sell? Okay. I got one of those. Alright, thank you, sir. Hey, doggo.
Hey, boy. Come here.
He's a good boy. Oh, yeah, that was really good, Ashley. You be well.
Thanks.
Alrighty. Now, we can head on to the zebra and the lion and the tiger. Fingers crossed, we'll see how that goes. Yeah, we'll see how this goes. Margaret. Let's find out.
What can I do for you?
Alrighty.
I don't think you got any idea about the land you walk in, do you? What us raiders gave for.
Now what? You alright?
This town's a tinderbox, and you might be the spark, you understand?
I ain't here to cause trouble.
Chill out, dude.
Yeah.
This. What does it say on the map? Fence. A peculiar business operating out of a colorful trailer just outside of town of Rhodes. The shopkeeper here is a craftsman with an interest in unusual artifacts. Have you got any dinosaur bones?
Welcome.
Hi.
You just discovered my little shop here?
Yeah, I did. Dynamite. Tomahawk. One single tomahawk designed for chopping wood or taking targets down with a powerful blow. Fair enough, I'm full of those. Alright, I'm grab one of those. Okay, got three of three. Cool. Ooh, predator bait. I might need that. Lockbreaker. Yes. Yes, I would like that. Thank you. Yeah, you have all sorts of things. Hides your identity while committing crimes. Oh, wow. Damn. These are unique kinds of hoods. Metal skull mask. Psycho mask. Damn. Do I need them if I've got my bandana? Creepy. Ooh, so these are the pamphlets of how to do that stuff. Ooh, a recipe to craft a horse meal. Pretty good. Special horse stimulant, special horse medicine, volatile fire bottle, incendiary buckshot. Damn, you do got some crazy things, sir. Thank you for your time.
New patron.
And you can
welcome,
craft?
Welcome.
Wow. Very unique indeed. I just had a pig freaking out. Talisman. Fascinating.
Right. What is it with folks in the masks lately?
Oh, God. No. Let me take off my mask. How? How do I take it off? There we go. Good. Cool. I just wanted to purchase it, but I don't want to wear it. All right, what an interesting place. Alrighty. Let's continue.
Yeah.
Got some cool things from there. And I got predator bait in case I need it, and I'm so glad I got that lock break. I've wanted that for a hot minute.
Just show the damn lock and be done with it.
And have it bounce off and hit me? You don't know what you're talking about.
What the? Why don't you mind your business and keep walking, huh?
Don't have to tell me twice.
Okay, should I
That's right. Run along,
kill
now.
Them? Where am I in relation to? It's pretty close. Shouldn't risk it. Do be funny, but there was a guy who rode just there. And oh, look, another person, so it could be a lot of witnesses if I shoot him. So I just feel like it's a bit dangerous. To try capitalize on that amongst a lot of witnesses so close by to Rhodes. This area here. Van Horn Lugras. What does that even mean? Doesn't say anything. Lonnie's shack. Place abandoned? It's boarded up. Stay out, plague. Oh. Oh, that's mortifying. I found. Wow, all boarded up, eh? That's crazy. That's really sad. Ill with sin. And I just can't understand what that says. Wow. That's eerie as all hell. These poor people. God, imagine going there at night time. I'd actually poo myself. That's genuinely scary enough during the daytime. What the hell? Alright, guys.
Yep.
That sucks. died of like some kind of plague. I don't know if it's like TB, scarlet fever, bubonic, I don't know, chickenpox. God, there's so many things that could have been. What an awful, awful thing. Farm there. Ah, oh, cool, it's a stable. Oh yeah, I think I've been to that one. Maybe. I can't remember. Stables. Beautiful.
Yeah. Okay there, boy.
Look how gorgeous this area is. How are the poor locals gonna feel if there's a freaking tiger and lion just in their backyard? Like, I'd be mighty confused. Just go this way. Margaret's missing zebra was last spotted in this area. Good lord. So it's a donkey painted as a zebra? Hey, hey.
Whoa, easy. Easy there, easy. Whoa there.
It's a mule, not even a donkey. Oh, sweet ting. Okay, now do I lasso him?
There we go. Hey now.
Alright. This is so goofy. Okay, I'll get rid of that waypoint and then. Wait, where the heck? Oh. There. Beautiful. Okay, let's go back this way.
Come on now.
The zebra has been calmed and will now follow you. Oh, okay, so I don't need a lasso.
Easy.
What even happened? I don't know. Look what he's following. That's what matters. Yay. That's a good zebra. This poor freaking mule.
This funny to you?
This funny to you? Yeah. Because you got a freaking mule painted like a zebra. Okay, in that case, what's the lion and the tiger gonna be, huh? What's all that gonna be? Firstly, if it's a house cat, like a kitty cat, I'll be very happy. But I have no idea. Margaret, you fool.
It's just a donkey, idiot.
Nothing to see here, folks. Just a man and his zebra-painted mule. Average Tuesday, I reckon. You're a good mule. You're very sweet. Sorry. We go. Home sweet home. Alright, you fool. What are your other two animals then?
Good grief! You found him!
Yep.
Our zebra!
Well, you can't call him that.
You can't call him
Although
that.
He's as much a zebra as you are a lady animal wrangler.
Yep.
Oh dear, you're missing the point, aren't you? It's an illusion, a trick of the eye to bamboozle the senses. Profound comprehension.
Hoodwink your audience?
Hoodwink? Our audiences? Dear boy, don't be so dreadfully literal. No one will pay for the truth. They only pay for deception. The allure of the stage, dreams and reality. What is the greater conscience? Lassoing some poor beast on the plains of Mumbo Jumbo Land and shipping it here so it can dance the polka? Or turning there in the glare of those arc lamps, something mundane into something extraordinary?
Right.
It's the difference between prose and poetry. It's alchemy. We're selling dreams, dear boy.
Okay.
Well, as long as you don't pay me with tickets to your show.
Yes. Well, it's not everyone's cup of tea.
And speaking of my payment.
Of course. I shall make it worth your while. But, first...
What trickery are you going to use?
We shall need the whole menagerie back before we can think about that. My assistant's gone for the tiger.
Tiger?
Yes, yes. And taken our remaining lion in case it could lend a paw. They're down there on Caligar Way. Please. I hate to ask.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
I wonder what animal this is going to be. Honestly, it's so worth it, even if I get no money out of this scammer, because this is just the craziest thing I can think of. All right, where's the tiger? Oh, down here, eh? Can do. The goofiness never ends. Thanks, Margaret. This place. Oh, this is where we recently stole from, isn't it? I think. Yeah. Ooh, is there anything in the chimney? No. But yeah, this is where we recently robbed. Good times, Sean and I. Jeez, how did I not get that before? It's salted meat. Oh. Stunning. Right, well, it's been real to rob it twice.
What?
I'm having a great time. What is this tiger gonna be? It can't possibly be a house cat. So, what's the alternative?
Easy. You're okay.
How far away are we? Okay, yeah, we're far enough, I think.
Government in the free state of Lemoyne.
Oh, God. Please don't.
Oh, he did it. I was going to intervene, but he already killed him. Damn.
Come on now, boy.
Sorry, I was too slow to react.
Yep.
Sometimes I... That's sad.
I wonder if our point was effective if we keep killing everyone.
So... confused what they mean. There's federal agent. What? Oh. I'm sorry I couldn't save him. I should have, but I was too slow trying to learn what the situation is, and I still don't even quite know what it is. Nice little farm up there. What sort of animal do we have here? Stripey? Stripey? Is it gonna be a cat? Hey, ma'am.
Hey, mister.
Oh.
Miss.
Howdy, mister.
Hi. You are mighty cute.
You lose a tiger?
Yeah, you found one?
No, I found your caravan.
You're very cute.
Now, Margaret said that you might need a hand.
Oh, you weren't wrong. That tiger's missing. I sent our best lion out to find him, and now he's missing too. It is a right old predicament.
Your lion's from Timbuktu, weren't he? Oh,
from Valentine, I think.
Oh.
He's more of a kind of dog than a lion, but in a certain light, a feller could never tell.
It's a dog. To search for a cat, isn't it?
Into them shrubs over there.
Okay. Oh my god. That's so funny.
I'll see if I can find this track.
Alright. Okay. Where are we gonna find this doggo?
I got it.
So it starts off this way. Yup.
Trail! These are paw prints.
Yeah, paw prints to go with the lion paw. Yeah, lime paw prints, that's for sure.
You paint this dog? There's some pigment here.
Yeah, they made it orange, didn't they? Oh my god.
Looks like blood to me. Shit.
Uh-oh, did the dog eat... I mean, sorry, did the lion eat the tiger?
Your dog.
That's sad.
Dog.
Hey, boy. Oh, where's the rest of them?
I think a cougar took them.
Oh, that'd be Stripey. And I always thought they got along.
The cat ate
your
the dog?
Your tiger is a wild cat?
Uh-huh.
What else? You still need it back?
Oh, yes, sir. She's our star attraction.
I'm sure she is.
Let's hope it wants the other half of its dinner.
Damn. I'm gonna use the dog as bait. He's still got this wig on it.
Really?
I'm gonna put him in your wagon. You find somewhere to hide.
Oh. Well, behind that log then.
Okay.
All right. Well, this is so weird. Damn.
Grubs up. Stay down. She won't be too far away.
I went out to find a tiger.
Cougar, you mean?
And I end up losing a lion.
Yeah, a dog.
A dog.
Haven't any luck.
Well, if that's what you're dealing with, you didn't have any luck to be.
Yeah, come on. This poor dog got eaten by a freaking cougar.
What you got in this life. It's what you make of it.
Well, that's very wise of you. Especially when you're lacking zebras and tigers. Hey, keep your head down. It's coming.
Look, I really don't think she'll eat the dog.
Oh
like
my
I
god.
Said, they was friends.
And they, yeah, they painted her. Oh god. She is a wildcat.
Oh, well, I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in.
Cougar doesn't deserve to be locked up and with all these right. Weird people.
Let's go.
We got her. Okay, drive, will you? And I'll keep an eye on her.
Sure thing.
This is ridiculous.
Let's get her back to Mr. Margaret.
Mr. Margaret.
I would have thought since they was close and all.
Well,
clearly you're not.
Turn on each other.
Yeah, and clearly you're not feeding them well enough.
Viciousness comes easy. I mean, I should know. I've run with a few of them myself.
Is that right?
Yeah, I've got this wild dog called Micah.
Hey, I realize I ain't properly introduced myself.
Sally Nash.
Nice Arthur to meet you, Sally.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Tell me, Miss Nash, how you end up in this racket?
I guess it's always been my inclination, you know? Wild beasts and the like.
Okay.
Margaret, we got to talking, and you can probably tell in this field he's the ace of spades.
He's a card, all right.
He's a card, all right.
Modest hope one day to be the world's second bravest woman animal wrangler.
Well, I'd say you got that sewn up and then some.
You think? I hope so. Top five, at least. It depends on how many more fellers throw their hat in the ring.
Whoever painted her
days,
is the bravest.
Will actually be a female.
Oh, I don't know if that'll ever happen.
That's like Shakespearean plays when none of the actors were allowed to be women. It was only actors, not actresses. And they're like, a woman playing a woman in a Shakespearean role? We'll see if that ever happens. That's so funny that these are once, I don't know, aspects.
We lost the main road around here when the dust was up. Be careful or you might get wrecked too.
Damn.
Okay. You know the only thing to do in a dust storm is wait it out?
Mr. Margaret's a lot of things, but best female navigator ain't one of them.
I imagine you're right about that.
We was tearing around here, looking for any kind of landmark, when over we go. Whole caravan toppled. Found each other and some shelter, but when the wind died down, the animals was gone.
But now they're back. Some of them, at least.
Some of them.
Thanks to you.
I mean, you got the dog as well, but it's, maybe
you
just a few bones now.
I'm sure there'd be a place for a fellow like
you. Oh, thank you. To better women than me. Stop, that's incredible. But in the late 1800s, early 1900s, these sideshows were pretty big. They were successful, I believe.
There it is.
Or at least busy.
Couldn't miss him if you wanted to.
Mr. Margaret!
I see you found each other.
Yep.
Sure did, Mr. Margaret.
Jolly good, jolly good.
You know, tarn and feathering a donkey is
one
thing.
Yeah, painting a wild cougar.
Makeup.
But playing dolls dressed up with a wild animal, you're gonna want to be a lot more careful.
Strappy ape king, Mr. Margaret. I saw her do it.
I always thought they got along.
Oh, she liked him just fine.
Yeah, she liked him just
fine. Chops and asked for seconds. Hey, speaking of which, you got any more word on that runaway lion, or are you gonna pay me for these misfits?
Look, I'm well aware that we're not Royal Command performance material. Daddy, you were right, goddamn you! But I can't.
Daddy, you were right, goddamn you!
Drury, bloody lane.
You got any word on the lion?
Yes, yes, I've got word on the lion.
Wasn't
shit is the word.
The dog,
someone's
the lion?
Near Emerald Ranch. As you know,
I thought the dog was
the
lion.
Very short on lions, so I'd be very grateful.
So you have another lion.
All kinds of grateful.
There's only one kind of grateful I care about.
So long, mister.
Be a dear and fix me a gin.
Golly goodness. Emerald Ranch for the lion. This is so goofy. Alrighty. All right, let's find us a doggo. You okay, sir?
Mister?
You okay?
You look like a man on a mission.
All right, we're getting out of here. See ya. Just checking in.
Yeah.
And what I might do currently... Oh yeah, I can't do when I'm on the horse. Stop over here and just clean my guns. Maintain. So I've got that gun oil back at camp whenever. Cool. Clean. Nope, let's clean you. I don't have any more gun oil. Cool, that's fine. Alrighty. Alrighty. Beautiful. There's a house down there. Pig farm. Branch. Lovely.
Hold it tight. We caught a sapling here.
Everyone okay?
I am holding it. Hold yours.
Can't find that.
I saw its claws. That's enough for me.
Who's talking? Huh? Is anyone... Who's... Oh. Oh, there we go. What's happening? Okay, that's probably the lion. Y'all okay?
What's the ruckus, boys?
Get back! We got a cursed creature.
Yeah, I can take him off your hands.
Mean as a hellcat.
It looked like a lion to me.
That's a dog in there.
A dog.
Now, a dog.
You excuse me.
I'd like to get that dog.
Step aside.
What?
I said step aside.
Into the barn, oh God.
Yeah, boy.
Didn't look like no dog.
Didn't look like no dog.
Come here, boy. Let's go.
That's not a dog. Oh, it's outside? Wait, what?
Look what you've done.
What?
Look what you've done!
What did I do? How?
Bitch. I'll take care of it.
find the lion. Oh god. Is it another cougar? What's going on? Oh, it's an actual freaking lion. What?
Easy, boy. Easy. Shit.
I died. Let's retry that. Why did they have an actual freaking lion?
Woo, he got it! He shot the thing! Is it dead? I pray the thing's a goner.
It's dead. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry, Emerald Ranch.
Whoever owned that beast got some answering to do.
Yeah. What the freak? Oh, horse. Oh, cow. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, sir. May as well. Sorry. Well, that was a travesty. You silly people. It was an actual freaking lion. Okay, let me just go here and see if I can set up camp. Yeah. I have nothing to say, what the heck? Oh boy. Do one of these. Had it for longer. Till morning. That's some crazy business. I love Dutch like a father, but in many ways I love Hosea even more. He's kind and fair and like a human being. Dutch is something else. This bear was also something else. Size of a goddamn hotel. And it was mean with it. He loves Hosea. Here's Strauss. He's back lending money. Yeah, he hates what he does. Cool, those herbs. A father and son pair of clowns at some farmhouse. But I imagine I shall. Yeah, met a lady scientist, yep. A little bit insane, but she's cool. Yeah, that was messed up. Black Bell, what a woman. If she was younger and I was in the market for a woman to go killing with, what a pair we could have made. She told me old boy Calloway was a poser and a liar. Big surprise. She was so cool. Yep. Try to kill me. He was nasty. Oh, yeah. Yeah, seems harmless. yep. Wildlife photographer. When off drinking with young Lenny, thanks to my own peculiar genius for trouble when drunk, the evening did not go quite according to plan, but somehow neither of us got killed or arrested for murder. I mean, we got arrested, of course, but not for murder. Because he let us out. Yeah. Bit of a mess. Smithfield Saloon. Ooh. Wow, to his wisdom. Getting grazed. It was quite a time. Sad. Crazy's one of them. Usual nonsense. All right, that's enough for now. I'll keep reading.
Go, boy.
In the future, we'll head here and then back to camp. Gotta let them know what happened. Very quickly, folks. There we go. Alright. These mad folks sent me to get an actual lion. that they let loose in North America. Dog, what the heck? Alrighty, you freaks. No lion.
Sally, get the cages ready.
Yes, sir, Mr. Market, right away.
A man-eating lion. You didn't think. It might be
to let me know.
For me to know that this time the animal was actually real, you moron.
Steady on. I clearly stated that we were looking
You haven't clearly stated anything in all the time I've known you. That could have been a goose for all I know.
A goose. We'll hardly get them to their feet for the curtain call. Bring on the king of the beasts, on the other hand, and they feel the roar. And they, well, look about as surprised as you do. What have you done with him, if you don't mind me asking?
I killed him. He's dead.
Bloody hell. This is rum, old boy.
Well, it was him or me. Now, pay me.
Yes.
He's trying to kill me.
Of course. I have just the thing. And what a treasure it is. You're a lucky man, sir. Very lucky man. From the mines of El Dorado.
Yes, it's a glass.
As the rainforest. As clear as the Amazon. And as dear as all the gold in the Andes. One man's labor is but a trifle compared to this jewel's true value. Wait! I shouldn't. What would Daddy say?
Your daddy ain't here, and we had a deal.
Yes, of course. A promise is a promise. Sally, get the wagons moving.
Ain't we waiting for the lion?
He's in the great hunting ground in the sky. Good day, sir, and thank you. But we really must be getting along.
You're weird.
So long.
So long, Mr. Morgan.
So long.
You see me? I'll be topping the bill, I promise. Or at least I'll be on the bill.
Emerald. Oh, okay, so it's an actual precious gem. That's good.
Let's go, boy.
That's crazy. Oh my goodness. Well, lovely. Isn't that nice? Alright. Let's head back home. What a literal wild goose chase that was. Bizarre.
Thank you.
sorry, I was worried for a train.
I couldn't have drawn it prettier, no sir.
Oh, hey, mister! Remember me? Come on
oh,
over!
Oh, yeah.
How you doing today?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, you see this here?
Mm-hmm.
American ginseng. Take a feller from not too bad to hearty as buck in no time.
Flair.
Really something. Yep, you don't find this every day. Dose this in your medicine, give it some zip. Believe me.
Whatever you're selling, I ain't buying.
Anyway, I ain't gonna use all of this, so feel free to help yourself to whatever's left.
Why, thank you.
Take care now.
You too.
Well, thanks. Be well, friend.
I can't carry anymore. Cool. Alrighty, lovely. Sorry, fellas. I could have gone on either side, but I went right between them. Home sweet home.
Who's there?
It's me.
Arthur,
dumbass. Look what the cat dragged in.
Oi.
Beautiful. And then let's brush you, because you're dirty.
There, boy.
Lovely. Okay, should probably, I guess, finish it with fishing with Kieran. Yeah. May as well. Oh, fishing with Javier. Okay. Sure.
What are you doing?
Going fishing. The rivers around here, famous for the smallmouth bass. Fella I met showed me a couple spots. You want to join me?
I can't fish with you. You're far too good.
Oh, come on, come on. Hey, join me. I'll show you a couple of my tricks.
All right. It's just down
There's
here.
There's a spot Not too far from here.
Not too far? All right.
I've been wanting to try out.
Glad you're so excited about this.
You will be too when you start pulling out smallmouth. Come on. The fish should be hungry for their breakfast.
I thought you said it wasn't far.
Too far to walk, though. Yeah, come on.
Okay, as long as it's not far, far.
That's my boy.
Been a while since we rode out, just you
yeah,
and me.
Yeah, the two of us.
Since we went looking for John.
Yes, literally.
Already seems long ago. How you feeling about everything? Been a strange couple of months.
Hey, you know, I can't even return to my country because the price on my head is so big. This is nothing exactly new to me. And I'll always be loyal to Dutch. He sees the world the same as I do. If we have to fight, we fight. If we have to run, we'll run. If we must die, we'll die, but we'll stay free.
And Dutch, you don't feel like, well, that he's doing things a little differently now?
Ooh.
You saw what happened with that girl on the ferry.
No fight, good or bad, is won without blood. I know that better than most.
Okay.
I think too many people are focusing on Dutch when they should be looking at themselves. What they could have done better.
So did you see what went down?
Maybe you're right.
We'll cut through to the right here. Ha! The other day, I rode down to the Lanahatchee River. I caught some beautiful steelhead trout.
Yeah, I got some steelhead trout too.
No. The Lanahatchee. It runs right near here.
Yeah, but it's pronounced Lanahatchee.
Why is everything in English said differently than it's written?
I know, right?
Make us feel stupid?
Oh, you're asking the wrong
But yeah, English is a language full of exceptions to the
okay,
rules and then
the
exceptions to the exceptions. it's all very confusing.
Let's go try our luck.
Oh, God.
Pretty country.
Beautiful.
Come on, let's go see what's biting.
This is a little freshwater lake.
You take this spot, Arthur. I'm going to cast from over to the right there so we're not in each other's way.
Ready.
Time of day really can make a difference. They feed early morning or late evening.
Yeah.
That's when the insects are more likely to be out. We're lucky we got such nice weather. But rain can be good. Sometimes big fish think the raindrops are insects.
Oh, is that why? Ooh, what's happened?
Well, I guess it's still relaxing, even if I don't catch anything. Sort of like staring at the sky.
It's your bait, I think. Come use some of mine.
Oh, it's not the bait. It's me. I've always been a poor fisherman, especially compared with you and Jose.
Just try some of mine. Here.
Thank you.
Crickets.
Thanks.
Okay. Cool. Nice.
He's a fighter. Trick is, let him tire himself out. Look at that.
Nice.
Well done.
Good job.
Told you it wasn't that hard. Okay, let's try for another. Make sure he's tired before you reel in. Another one. Come on. Look at that. That's a good looking fish.
Well done.
He's small, but might make a nice meal.
Nice. Is this one mouth? Yeah. Perfect.
Oh, keeping you.
Press triangle to
one more and then head back. What do you say?
That's cool. Fine with me.
Agreed. One more.
Another one.
Damn. Javier's really good at fishing. I'd say better than this is an angry one. Better than Hosea.
That's a good looking fish.
Well done.
I was thinking. You remember that stagecoach we held up in Nevada?
Yeah. It was a tip from that crooked lawman in Reno.
We open the door and it's full of women and children. Rich, but women and children. So we let it go and read in the newspaper that the O'Driscolls robbed and killed them all the next day further down the trail.
Oh.
Yep. You know, way back in the day, Home O'Driscoll and Dutch were sort of friends.
I'd imagine they had a history.
Well, not friends, but they had an understanding. Then Combs' mean streak got meaner, and Dutch wanted to try to live a different way.
And now, here we are. Another one.
Good job.
Come on. Look at that. That's a good-looking fish.
Well done.
I heard people talk about a huge smallmouth in Lake Owenjila, west of Strawberry, over in Big Valley. You need a lure to catch one that big, though.
Another yep. One.
Pull to the left as he goes right. Another one.
Lovely. Cool. And then we can go back. Good job, Javier. All right, we did it.
Not bad, you see? It's the bait.
It ain't just the bait.
I'm going to head back. You want to join me or...
Yeah.
Keep trying for these bastards.
No, I'll join you. Head back with Javier.
I'll come.
Okay, let's go.
Beautiful. Oh, that's sweet. That was nice for them to have that moment and to kind of talk things out a bit. They don't like to talk much when they're like at camp, like the girls do. They're down to just sit down and talk, but the guys prefer it when they're out and about doing something else that they can almost distract themselves from the fact that they are admitting to, I don't know, feeling things that... maybe, oops, sorry, like fear or concern or anything like that. So that's cool. Lovely. hair. Beautiful. Okay, cool. And now I can claim my gun oil, finally.
Yeah. So, what do you think?
What do you mean?
About those two families. Oh. Rich ones in the big houses.
I don't know.
Go have a look around.
I will.
See what you can find out. Calmly, I mean.
Of course, sure. Yeah. No ruffling.
Dutch and I, we both think there's money to be made.
All right.
I hope so. I'll see what I can find out.
All right, perfect.
Crazy fool. I heard everything you said. I was sleeping, you lunatic.
Oh, boy.
Make me angry.
Oh, who's feeding?
You'll start howling at some other man.
Let's give in some... that. And that. What is going on? Uncle's fighting. Okay, let's give to the donations, and then I have my gun oil. Hey, John.
All right.
Give all the debts. And give money. Yeah, 25. Let's see what else is in the ledger that we can do. Local farms are selling off old coops. Yeah, I guess so. Or yeah, a proper horse station. That could be good. Yeah, might do that next. Cool.
Bloody hey, Holly.
Molly. What you thinking about?
Nothing much.
Fair enough.
Okay, well, I'll leave you to it.
Well, I'm not much company. Take care.
Now let's get that gun oil that I got given. Gun oil! Woohoo! Yeah! Anything? Because I know we're in warm-ish weather. Yes, we could do maybe, maybe this with, change of shirt.
Mr. Strauss. Hello.
Yeah, can wear something like this with no oh no, it looks pretty cool with the coat too, actually. Yeah, I'll do that for now. Change it up a little. Cool. Okay. I should also sleep? Yeah, let me just sleep like maybe a tiny bit. Let's see how long I can. Till evening, till night. No, let's sleep till the next morning. 15 hours. He needs it. He needs a big sleep. Then I can contribute more money and check on the Greys. This whole Romeo and Juliet situation that we're going to try profit off of. Oh, yes, and new journal entry. Let's check out some more. This was, yeah. Where the last were. Continuing on. I met a fella called Miss Margaret. Disaster. Yeah, that was really sad. A while ago, I met an odd man dressed as a lady, animal trainer. Are all Englishmen that weird, I wonder? All his animals were as fake as the rest of his act until I was to find and retrieve a real lion from somewhere or other in Africa. I thought was going to be another dog, but no, it was a real lion. Thing looked like it wanted me for its next meal. Yeah, that was scary. Strange English maniac. Never go on stage. Off they went. Beautiful. All right, I'm up to date with the journal. Let me contribute maybe some physical things. Hi, good morning. What is this? Oh, yeah. I'm obviously not reading it, just checking it out. Cool. Alrighty. There we go. I was like, why isn't it popping up? Let's this time contribute items. Like that emerald. 50. Hell yeah. Alright. Sounds good. Beautiful. Alrighty. Let's head over, shall we? Morning, Lenny.
You okay, Lenny?
Yeah. Lemoyne wouldn't be my first choice, but this is a good spot.
Yeah, it's I agree with both. Now. Morning, Hosea.
We should go fishing again soon. That was fun.
It was fun.
Yes, I needed that to clear the mind after everything.
Yep.
Beautiful human beings. I really like them. Hey, Brad.
Okay, fella.
Let's go check out the Gray residence. Off we go.
Yeah.
Kind of spooky music. What was up with that? Don't do that. Okay, no, now it's getting into a groove. A little bit ominous.
Yep.
Okay, weird music. Cool, but I'm good as long as I'm just not carrying anything. Not using my weapons, I'm being a good boy.
Shop's open. Come get your meat.
I won't do the Dutch mission now because I feel like that's going to make something happen and I don't want it to. But I'll do the gray house. That was the next thing I needed to do. Learn about them but in a non-violent way.
Woo!
Damn. Yeah, I hate the Braithwaites. Don't want to get involved in none of that. Hello there, I'm a friend of the Greys.
What do you want?
This here the Grey plantation?
Yep.
Hey, look, I've been helping the sheriff.
Yeah, the sheriff.
Wanted me to have a sheriff word Gray. With a few of the folks on the property here.
Emmett Lee.
Yeah, Lee.
All right. Have a word. But I ain't got the time to help you.
No worries. Blast. I can do it myself. Lovely. This place already gives me the creeps. Can I talk to you? Nope. Okay, do I speak to someone specifically? Can I speak to you?
Hey, can you talk?
I look like I can talk. You want to talk or try Bo Gray? Out by the storehouse.
Storehouse. Thank you very much.
Won't lift a hand, but sure can move his lips.
Thank you kindly. Here we go. Hey there.
Huh. I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he's hoping.
Yes.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here. And suddenly, there's a whole
course of true love.
Of mysterious, but strangely
this is the guy who's in that place. In Romeo's situation.
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Are you secretly normal?
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope.
Penelope.
Possible.
Well, love tends to be complicated.
Yep.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, exactly. The sheriff. Grandson of old Murdo Gray.
Yeah.
We Grays have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty.
Romeo and Juliet. Tale as old as time.
Some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Grays, we've always got money. No brains mine, but money.
Well, okay.
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter.
Okay.
And this bracelet. Please.
Cool.
Oh, look out for their guard. They're worse with strangers than ours are.
Damn, okay. That's gonna be rough. Sneak into the grounds.
And good luck.
Okay, thanks. Is that all I can do regarding the snooping around here? I mean, it's very guarded. But I guess that's that. Hey, Hoisy. Alrighty. Okay, music. Cool. This music is really nice, though. So couldn't I just give it to Hosea, who's scoping out the Braithwaite side? So I feel like it'd be better that than tangling myself between the two. But I think I'm gonna have to. Spotted on horseback. Oh, so I'm not even allowed to, like, be seen here. Okay. So in that case... That's gonna be tough. Let's go to... here if I can. Save. Got this. I've got throwing knives for a more stealthy kill, shall I need? I can't kill them. Okay, so just by being alerted. Okay, good to know. Okay. Hey, ma'am, please don't freak out.
Are you Penelope Braithwaite?
Well, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Oh, he is so...
strange?
Strange.
A little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages or... well, I don't
valid.
Know. Cave people, perhaps.
Oh, thank you.
Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful, like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
I've not, but...
well, neither have I, but my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are there's something else.
Mm.
You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say, except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well.
Well, kind of.
Maybe a bit. But here. If you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure.
Let's get out of here. Could have been this little bit of that. And it's like we were never here. Lovely. Now, where do we want to go? Quite a lot of area that we can't be in. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's just get out, I guess. You're a good boy. Out the we go. Whew. That was a little tricky. Not too bad. All right, so cool, made it out of there. I guess I've got to give it back to him. At least I'm allowed to go there. Lovely. Pig screaming every now and then. Hey, sir.
Hey, boy.
What kind of dog are you? A Labrador. Oh, yeah. That's a good boy. Where's the smoke coming from?
What the hell's wrong with you all?
Gang camp. Interesting. What kind of gang are they?
Just feels like we ain't getting nowhere. It's the end of the century. It seems like we ain't much further on than we was in 65.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe not. We can still live free. We can still say we don't recognize you or answer to your laws. There could be one man with a
truth. Interesting. They're kind of similar to our group then. So if I were to call my horse here, could they hear that? Okay, let's save and see if I should be a little sneaky sneaky. You stay, horsey, you stay. That's not a good spot. Okay, let's see if I should do it or not. How did you survive that headshot? Okay, let's see how worth it was. Ah, oh, they were the Lemoyne Raiders. Buy a bandolier gun belt so you can hold more ammo. Cool. Alright, nice. Get wrecked, Raiders. Cool. Okay, can't take the chewing tobacco.
Ooh. Kill him quick! You got misery coming your way, Trick!
Oh my god, I'm stuck. Sorry, boys. I was just getting started, you know? Alrighty. Sorry, horsies. So there should be another guy. Oh yeah, here you are. And here. All right, what else do you have? Fine brandy. Oh, whoopsies. No, 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 I don't want to do that. Oh, God, sorry. I thought I was picking up something here. Gun oil. For raiders and looters, they didn't really have much. Kind of sucks. And cash. I'm mighty disappointed. Thank you, horsey. Alright, let's go. Wasn't really worth it, sadly. Like a hole. Okay, Bo, I got a letter for you, but I won't announce that loudly.
You know me, I'm on official business for the family. All right, come on.
Thank you. Just greet them, but I can't ask them anything.
Good morning, mister.
Good morning. Have a good day. Bo? Where are you at, Bo? There you are.
You got my money?
Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. But it'll cost you. I can't be bothered.
I can't be bothered. Thank you, Arthur. Oh,
thank you. My God. What a woman.
What a woman.
She's... This'll get her killed for sure.
What?
Women's suffrage. Around here, they don't even like men voting. They bring back the monarchy, given half the chance. Progress is a dirty word in these parts.
Yeah.
unlike incest.
Excuse me?
Yeah, facts.
My cousin Matilda, I want to marry Penelope.
Oh, you have to marry your cousin?
But they're gonna... They'll kill her at one of those rallies they're holding.
You guys need to run away.
You gotta help.
No, I'm afraid I don't want no part of it.
I'll pay. My family, we've still got some money.
Fine. Just no more running around with letters.
Thank you. Come on. We better get going.
What's the plan? Okay, I'm out my house.
Mount up, all right. And follow me to Rhodes.
Okay.
Come on, come on. Yeah.
We'll go around. Well, I needed to go to Rhodes anyways. Yeah, if you guys want to marry, just, you're gonna have to run off. I'm sorry, you can't do it here with your families. You're gonna have to get out. You know what I'm saying?
Easy, boy. Calm down.
I can't be calm. If we don't get there in time, my true love may be shot.
If she wants to rally, you gotta let her rally.
Well, good as the cause is, I can't let her become a martyr to it. I want to marry a flesh and blood woman. Not a statue in her honor.
I'm sure they know what they're doing.
There. There they are.
Bo, what are you doing here?
I cannot let you go through with this. You'll be killed.
I'm prepared to die for the cause, Bo.
You need to run away together.
Do something, please.
Do what? Fight this mob.
We must.
They need me alive.
This is no laughing matter, sir. They need protecting from certain elements. Mostly my family. I beg you.
I'll tell you what. Your friend here can drive the wagon for us. It'll allow us to shout all the louder.
Hooray!
Sure.
Miss Calhoun. My friend here says he can drive the wagon.
If you want.
Well, Olive Calhoun.
Nice to meet you.
Normally I like to drive myself, but today I feel like a man joining us sends the right message.
Yeah, well, especially like I doing the work for you. Hell yeah.
Protest march before, madam.
Well, just treat us like the sheep and the folks attacking us like the wolves, and I'm sure you feel right at home.
All
right,
fair.
Shall we go?
He's so out of his depth.
Our song is a good one, and we know our cause is a pure one.
Yes, hell yeah.
Let liberty reign.
What a sad excuse of a reason to want to harm and kill women for them just wanting to. I mean, they're not the only ones.
Take us down Main Street, right through town to the steps of the Bank of Rhodes, Mr.
What was your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
They'll hear it all right.
Very good, very good. Mr. Morgan, are you an old friend of the movement?
I'm just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Well, our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan.
Thank you.
Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
Hope so. Oh, God.
Today, Sheriff, I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's a pretty dumb specimen, I grant it.
Take us just a little further, please. Those are the steps, Mr. Morgan. Stop in front there, and then all you need to do is listen.
Cool.
Ladies, get down.
Please be careful.
Go home! Shut your mouth!
What the hell is going on? Welcome here!
Oh, my God. Shit!
You men are pathetic.
And gentlemen, yeah. This is a great day for all of us.
Yeah.
For today is the day we begin to live as equals.
Equals! Ah.
Yes, equal, sir. Fair and equal.
This is unnatural. This is nonsense.
Fair, equal, and free, just as the Founding Fathers intended.
Founding Fathers, not Founding Mothers, you silly old goat.
So you're saying you don't respect the Founding Fathers' message?
What the hell are you doing here, boy?
Keep your voice down. I'm trying to listen to the speech.
Hello, darling cousin.
Don't you ever speak to me like that.
What are you doing here?
Listening, I suppose.
He has some chonky hands.
His cousin is a moron. Stop them from ruining the speech.
All right. What am I going to do, punch him?
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, you always were.
Bo, weren't we just leaving?
Who the hell is this?
Friend of both.
What? You'll hit me?
Come on.
Sir, can you not see how idiotic you are?
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
We gotta go before they think twice. Oh, Lord.
Oh, that's what we're supposed to do.
It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
All right. I'll follow you if you get on your dang horse. Oh, okay. There we go.
You don't want to go back and hear the speeches? I ain't voted before, but I'm kind of getting hot for voting rights.
Hell yeah, Arthur.
I don't know whether to take you seriously, Mr. Morgan. My cousins are my primary concern right now. If everyone knows about Penelope and me...
Everyone knows about Penelope and you. I know about Penelope and you, and I've been here all of 10 minutes. The sooner it's out, the sooner it's resolved.
The sooner it's dealt with.
No, I think you guys just gotta leave Lemoyne and go live your lives together.
We bury our secrets, and we bury them deep.
Your secrets and your treasure.
You know, Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter.
Ah! I'm sorry, Ozzy. This game, it's so hard to move and not get stuck on things. Oh, I can't even back it up. There we go. Okay. Alrighty. Sorry, continue what you were saying. Yep, you were saying.
Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter. No one's seen her in years. She weren't right, you know, and Penelope said...
I ain't heard about daughters. I heard about gold.
But Yankee gold? I fear that's just a story, Mr. Morgan. But I don't know. This is awful!
Nobody died. Ain't that awful.
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but...
You should leave.
Yeah, seriously, you and Penelope?
As soon as I have enough money. When my family... We have money, but I don't.
Yeah.
Is your family
from
very
them.
Rich?
Yes. Well, I believe so. But, they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a... artistic temperament, so...
Oh, is that what they call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke. Mm. I really love her. I do.
I know.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
Look, I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment.
Thank you.
Thank you. Excuse me.
Seriously, you and Penelope... Yeah, steal from your family and go live somewhere far, far away. Because you cannot be here if you want to be with her.
What?
It's too messy. Okay. Let's check out this Dutch mission then. Is there anything to see in here? Seems empty. predator.
You okay, boy?
Okay, we good. Okay, lovely. Now let's speak with Darlin' Dutch.
Short shrift me learned I can count real good all the way to six.
Well, I know.
Oh, wait, this isn't where he is. He just hitched his horse there. But he is in the sheriff's office. Making buddy-buddy with the sheriff, eh? Cool.
Of course. Oh, and here is my dear friend, Arthur Callahan.
That's me.
Boy is a hunter.
Mr. Callahan.
Boy is a killer. Arthur, you've not been introduced to Mr. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sheriff Gray.
How are you doing, sir?
I'm fine.
Are you drunk?
Tough business you boys had.
Yep.
Did? Well, there's no need to pretend with me, sir. Life can be tough.
It sure can.
And no man owes another anything.
No, sir.
That's what I always say.
I feel you were hard done by. Losing your employment like that.
Exactly.
But still, here in Rhodes, we have work enough for honest men.
That's some strong stuff. Still. Don't seem to be doing you any harm, I guess.
Exactly.
Whoa. Exactly. Oh.
I told what? You we was moving up in this world.
So what's happening?
Deputies.
Oh.
You finally lost your mind. Amongst these drunkards, hillbillies, and slavers? Good honest thieves like us. We're bound to be moralizers in a place like this. Oh, Sheriff Gray, you are back.
You are back.
There is shine in them woods, though, and it is cost in this county its good name and the state a whole lot of income. You boys wouldn't mind rooting it out. Maybe we'll make you permanent.
Maybe.
I gotta set me down a second.
Not a problem, sir. Not a problem at
That's
all.
What we do.
You are in safe hands now. And people waste time with the temperance movement. Liquor never dulled a good man's senses. Arthur, you ride with the deputy. Bill and I will follow.
All right.
Climb on up. Let's go.
Cool. I'm looking forward to learning what this is all about.
Archibald.
How you doing, Archibald?
How are you?
I'm good.
Pretty good.
And your friend is behaving himself?
Indeed.
Oh, yes. I think he's learned his lesson.
He's a good
fella. Congratulations on becoming a temporarily deputized citizen of Scarlet Meadows County.
Thank
Most
you.
Most towns just get bounty hunters to do their dirty work these days, but Sheriff Gray believes the law should keep the law. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you there's a chain of command here.
There is?
Dang straight there is.
Okay.
This is a dangerous business, but follow my lead and you'll be just fine.
You'll teach me well, won't you?
Hey! Archibald wants to remind us he's in charge. Of course!
Of course!
Who else would be?
You were a big help with them Anderson boys, and I put in a very good word with the sheriff on your behalf.
That's mighty sweet.
I appreciate that.
We rounded up the others soon after.
Yeah,
I'm pushing for the rope myself,
knocked them out.
But that's by the by.
So, these moonshiners.
Not just any moonshiners, Braithwaites. I told you about the Braithwaites.
Pretty sure you did.
old Cotton family had a fortune at one point until, well, a few changes in the labor laws. Now they're dealing in moonshine. We found their stills hidden all over Lemoyne. Quick as we destroy one, another one pops up.
Okay.
You could call it a pitiful fall from grace, if they had any grace to start with.
Exactly, if they had any.
I have no time for tax dodges.
For tax dodges.
Not to mention the fact that Catherine Braithwaite has a rather expensive interest in thoroughbred horses to maintain.
But that seems unnecessary.
I heard something about it being gold.
Yeah, what about that?
Well, that's the rumor.
Okay, well, do we want to look into it?
I think the others stole a fortune from them.
No,
but
crazy.
It happened so long ago, I don't know for sure if it's true.
Must be tough being rich.
So I imagine.
That bad rather suits you, Mr. W.
Yes, I thought so too.
Look at how he's dressed while wearing this badge.
I wouldn't go that far.
Whoa! Hold up. You see that wagon?
Yep. And I see two X's on the ground. Which means bodies. What hath happened? Gosh.
Keep your eyes open. You could try washing once in a while.
Do we not investigate? Like, what do?
No. This must have happened recently.
Okay, well.
Hey, come have a look at this. Look. Suit and tie. One bullet clean through the forehead. Well, my money says this is the handiwork of a gang called the Lemoyne Raiders.
Oh, yeah, I dealt with a few of those before.
I've run into them.
Let's see if we've got any identification. Okay. We should get going. I'll send someone over here later to clean this up.
Yeah. What a mess. He won't let me mount. Oh, do I have to wait for him to be on it first? There we go, yeah.
Would you mind taking the reins? I want to have a look at these papers.
All right.
Sure.
I'll direct you. Okay. Frederick Mitchell. Lemoyne State Legislator. Poor feller. Yes, this certainly smacks of the Raiders to me. Bunch of ex-army free staters without an ounce of respect for the law. That's 7 government officials they've murdered this year alone.
Okay, so that's what they were yapping about.
Not the nicest before.
Yeah, they're nasty.
Oh, and I know the Braithwaites are in business with them.
Oh, no, of course they would be.
Trash begets trash, my Uncle Reginald used to say. He had a few stories.
Reg knows what's up.
Town preacher and town sheriff. Drink a sailor under the table before breakfast.
Damn.
He had one tiny hand, like a child's, on the end of a grown man's arm.
Go right at
that's
the crossroads.
Weird. Why did he have a tiny hand?
People the Braithwaites are, selling moonshine to murderers. I tell folks don't even speak to him. Don't even look him in the eye.
I'm sure I wouldn't.
God, that's so funny. Is this another abandoned town?
They're right again here.
It's creepy how misty it gets around here. These parts get super misty.
Here we are. So what was I saying?
Something about the Braithwaites, I think.
Even saying that word makes me sick. Now, anyone we find here, we bring in alive, understood?
All right.
Round them up, and take this operation down for good. Come on. Let's see what we're dealing with.
We have to get them alive. See somebody just up ahead.
See? See? What did I tell you, boys? What did I say? I said this place was crawling with vermin, and we just found ourselves the rat's nest par excellence, as they say in Paris. My aunt, she went to Paris back in 78.
How will you handle this?
Well, the way I see...
Actually, let my friend here decide. He doesn't have your fine way with words, but he's definitely the man for the job.
Mm.
Let's split up. Arthur and Bill, me and Archibald.
Okay.
You boys want right or left?
I'll take left.
We'll take the left.
Let's stop these filthy degenerate right. Tax dodgers.
Tax dodgers. That's what we're mortified by.
Remember what he said. We need them alive.
Yep.
Let's just knock them out and then tie them up.
Got it.
Oh, you're just going across the water. Oops, my bad.
See one by the bridge over there?
You wait here. I'll be with him.
Okay. Make it quick. This bastard up. I think there's another one by the still.
By the way?
Hey, give me some room to work here.
Okay, sorry. Where am I going? Oh. This way, I guess? We in the bayou. Nice.
The last one. Get him to the wagon.
Will do. Beautiful. Okay, before I...
Good work, gentlemen.
You know, nothing to take. Late.
Just drop him with the others.
Cool. Now what?
I think that's it. Well, what do we do now?
We better destroy all this. Any of your boys can handle explosives?
Sure. Anyone but him.
So.
Thank you for your funny, don't you?
The last time I mention it, I swear.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Phil. Alrighty. Cool. Yep. So I just place it anywhere? Okay. And then do I light it? Ooh.
Hey! That belongs to the Mooring Raiders, you sons of bitches!
Yeah, I know.
Shit! We got men over here!
Hiya.
Dutch and get out of here.
Fine by me.
Quick, let's go before any more show up.
If they show up, you got it. Just checking that we can't go into any of these. Oh, we can go into this one. Nothing in there. Okay. Lovely. And one more. There we are. Stunning. All in a day's work. Honest sheriff, deputy work, sorry. Just some honest deputy work. Full of canned vegetables. Alrighty. In fact, I should probably eat some. Yeah. Stunning. Oopsies. Oh. Oh boy. Okay. That's a good cross. Okay. Alrighty, Bill. I'm back.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well, forgive me, but me and my men must return to our lives. Ah, seems like we failed to destroy the last of the moonshine.
Sure.
Would you like us to?
Well, I normally take it for personal consumption. It's sort of part of the job. But I better get back home.
Yeah.
Why don't I just take a jug or two and leave you boys the rest to show that there's no hard feelings on account of the war?
We are all Americans.
Of course. My cousin, Webster, he used to say some of us is not as American as others, if you know what I mean. Only I didn't quite. Come on, you degenerate, no-good, white trash, hillbilly piece of scum. I know you, Billy Lime.
Finally.
You've always been a
Finally.
Piece of crap. Come on, move.
We have a life right. On a land so stupid.
On a land so stupid.
So backwards that even we are like geniuses. Oh, get this stuff out of here. Come on.
He said, yes, sir. Okay. Yay, I get to ride with Dutch.
Should I stash this somewhere near camp, boss?
Yes, show it to Hosea. I'm sure he can find a use for it. Bit of trouble back there, Arthur?
Ain't there always? From what they was yelling, I think they were the buyers.
Old Archibald didn't ask too many questions, so neither should we.
True.
I ain't planning to.
That was worth the effort, though. Deputized and hiding in plain sight. These lawmen, these two families.
That's
I mean,
goofy.
I really think we can play this from all sides. It's got Hosea written all over it.
Yeah.
This is starting to sound like the young Dutch again.
What do you mean, young Dutch? I'm as strong as I have ever been. Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back?
Uh-oh. I think your horse will be faster. Accept.
Okay, you're on.
That's the spirit. Okay, on my word. Set, go!
Let's go.
You never were much of a rider.
We'll see about it.
This is cute. Just a father son ride off.
You okay there, old man?
Oh man. Oopsies. That's fine. Oh no. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, I'm stuck! Oh, that's so stupid. No! That's my fault. Oh. It's alright, I'm happy for Dutch to win. He's a good man. Oh my god.
Sorry, Arthur. This ain't looking good for you.
Ooh. Can I give my horse something? A stimulant. Whew. Even after getting stuck. It was closer.
I never knew you were quite so good at running away, Arthur.
Well, I never knew age had slowed you down quite so much.
Well, time is a bastard. When you get to be my age, well, you'll know that better than anything. Be well. I had fun with you today. You're, I was gonna say you're like a son to me.
But you know that.
But you're more than that.
That was beautiful.
Good.
Beautiful. That was so cool. I liked that mission a lot. All right, let me put some money in.
Mr. Morgan, I feel I made a bit of a fool of myself again.
You saying this? Oh. You reckon?
You saved my life again.
You reckon you made a little fool of yourself?
One day you'll save my, or my soul. Yeah, I'd like that.
Don't make fun of me.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Anyway, it wasn't a complete waste of time. I stole this from one of those awful men. You should have it.
Oh, thanks. What is it? Oh.
Well, thank you, but you were blind drunk.
I was drunk, but I never forget my manners. Be well, Mr. Morgan.
Okay, you too. Gosh, you're an absolute mess. Appreciate it, though. Alrighty.
Hey, Arthur.
What's going on?
Oh, sorry, one sec.
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said okay. You knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Hosea wants you to join him instead.
Oh, okay.
Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
Cool, thank you. All right, well, I'll do like 102, and then I can upgrade the horses thing. There we go, horse station.
Why don't you come here and sit down?
I ain't no O'Driscoll. I swear I proved myself.
All right, will you take it easy? Yeah, I'm just messing. So, what are you... I mean, where are you... You want to have a drink?
No. Oh, no thank you, sir.
Have a goddamn... drink!
Chill, Bill.
Well, have another drink.
Well, I can't right now, sir. I gotta go help with the horses. Sorry. Excuse me.
With the horses? Wait a minute. Come on back here. Well, come on back here, you hear?
You gotta chill, dog.
Shit.
What was all that about?
Good old Bill.
Arthur Morgan.
The bottle in your hand, there's a surprise.
I'm entitled to a drink.
Well, save some for the rest of us.
Yeah? Yeah, whatever.
All right.
Arthur, Arthur, how you been? I've been real worried.
What are you worried about?
What do you want? Don't be like that. just a few bucks. I'm short.
Get lost.
Well, I'll go try someone with a heart.
You do that.
You do that.
All right, well, I should be getting on.
All right, then.
So silly.
No rest for us idiots.
A proud Englishman.
Don't fight other men's battles, boy. And anyway, my family weren't even English.
They like apples, too, if you can find any. Hey, Arthur. Can I have a quick word?
Of course, let me just put this down. Hold up. Place that down, and then we'll chat. So you'll start a mission. Interesting. This is Molly, this is Hosea. Okay. Let me save and then I'll speak to her because I don't want to go off on another big thing yet.
Yes, Miss O'Shea.
Ah, call me Molly, would you?
You okay?
Arthur, how is Dutch? I mean, how does he seem to you?
I'm about the same as usual, I guess.
I really love him, you know.
Aww.
But if he... Like he always says, loyalty is everything, so...
Arthur! Excuse me, Miss O'Shea.
What you want?
I bring a gift. The great gift of information.
So you got some tip-off, so now... I can risk my neck and make you some money while you lounge around.
You know, well, Arthur, bitterness, it works on the inside as well as on your sour face.
If you say so, but you could go find some other fool to run your errands.
Bill, come on over here. Will you be my other fool? You too, Charles.
What are you talking about?
Arthur's above a little stick-up I heard about.
No, I'm not.
You just said...
Hey, I'll do it. As long as you ride with us.
Well, I got a serious medical condition.
Yes, you are a compulsive liar.
No need to be like that. Charles, have I ever lied to you?
I hardly know you.
Exactly.
I hardly know you.
It's easy, and I'll only take a small commission for my information. Now or never.
Then it's never.
Oh, God help me. Fine, I'll do it.
Well, what is it?
It's a supply wagon carrying payroll, but very briefly unguarded, apparently. As it passes through a crossroads near here where there's an old ruined church before it connects with the rest of the wagon train. Very easy pickings.
As long as we get paid or you get shot, I'm happy.
You are a sick man, Arthur Morgan. A very sick man indeed.
This way. Let's just see if it bars you. Yeah, bars you. I feel bad. I didn't end up talking to Molly. Alrighty, everyone. I'm not going to write off yet. I will do this in the next one. So I hope you all enjoyed. Please be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Thank you so, so much for being on this journey with me. And yeah, good thing I saved right before Molly, because we'll continue in the next one. Bye.